Hi and welcome to this tutorial. Today we will learn how to export and we will learn everything about the exporting in a Windows Movie Maker. To export our video, I prepare a video for you. It's just a random video from a Pixabay. You can go to a Pixabay and download freely this kind of videos for your projects or for practice or for commercial use. To export our movie, we can export our movie by going over here in a home tab. You can see if you are on a home tab, all to the right, you have this save movie tool. You just click save movie and you will get these options over here. You can also go to file and save movie and choose over here the best possible solution. So we have recommended setting, recent setting, common settings, phone and device settings, and you'll go to tablets, tablet settings, website settings, and all that settings. Makes no sense, I'm sorry to say that, but this is just for a specific purpose, just for specific purposes. Because you will always want to save for a high definition display, and if you hover over the tool, you will get this pop-up saying you can see the display size, the aspect ratio, the estimated file size, and so on. As you can see, I have a high definition video, so I will export it in a high definition, of course. The estimated file size for this is a 100, I'm sorry, just hover over again, is 173 megabytes. And if you see, if you want to export for a computer, you can see that this file size is only 40 megabytes, but the display size, it is smaller. So if you export for computer, it will be less, the video will be less quality. So, always choose high definition display, and you can just ignore these settings because you can make your own settings. Just scroll down to the bottom of this pane and click create custom setting. And over here you can see that we can make our custom setting. Just name it. For example, my custom setting, and you can specify the width, the height, the bit rate, and the frame rate of your video if you need for some specific projects, and you just need to click save, and it will take you to a Microsoft Windows Live, and video profiles. You need to save this custom setting in this folder, otherwise you will not be able to access your video settings. If you say it, for example, on your desktop, it won't work. You must save the setting where Movie Maker told you to do so. It's in Microsoft Windows Live and Video Profiles. So let's just click save and close. Just go again to a file, go to a save movie, and you can see in the recent settings that you have your custom setting, or you can access it on all the way down there in a my custom setting. This is your setting. This is our setting we just set up. So how to delete this one if you want to make another? Just click again, create custom setting, and in this drop down pane, you just search for your new setting. Okay, it's usually on the last one. It's my custom setting. I click it and just hit delete. And are you sure? I'm sure, yes. And just hit close and there is no more custom settings. That's all about custom settings. So let's just export it the highest possible, in the highest possible quality. Okay, this is for a high definition display. Click it. And I just export my movie. Let's says my other movie, and you can choose this as a Windows Media video file of MPG4, which is usually go with the MPG4. It's a very known format, and you can use it in various other tools and movie video editing tools So let's just hit save. And as you can see, the Movie Maker is exporting our video. It's called rendering. So we just wait a bit for Movie Maker to render our video. And it's done. It's done. Okay, and you will get this this pop-up window, so you can just play, open a folder, close. If I choose play, it will play my video in a VLC player. And this is it from the exporting in a Movie Maker. I hope this helped you. I have my other videos on my channel about Movie Maker tools and other stuff, so you can check them out. I hope this was helpful to you. Thank you, and bye bye.